Let's talk about the woman caught in adultery in John chapter 8. In an attempt to trap Jesus, the scribes and the Pharisees bring to Jesus a woman who was evidently caught in the act of adultery. They questioned whether or not Jesus would stone her to death, but his response was one that caught them off guard. He invited any one of them who was without sin to throw the first stone. One by one, they walked away until only Jesus and the woman remained. Jesus told the woman that he did not condemn her, and after a final exhortation to stop her sinful behavior, the scene ends. It's a pretty short story, really, only about 11 verses long. Something that you should know about this story is that it was most likely not part of the original contents of John's gospel. That may be a bit unsettling to you if it's the first time you've ever heard it, but hopefully with a little explanation, it'll make good sense to you as to why it's in the text of Scripture today. It's true, there is a strong argument that John chapter 7 verse 53 through John chapter 8 verse 11 was not actually in John's original recording of the gospel. Actually, there are a lot of manuscripts that have this story at several different places in the gospel. Some have it after John 7:36, some after 7:44, and some even have it after John 21:25. Many of those manuscripts make a note about the passage expressing doubt as to whether or not it's actually included. But most of the earliest and best manuscripts exclude it entirely. None of the Greek fathers comment on the passage until about the 12th century, which would be highly unlikely if it were part of the original text. On top of that, the general style and vocabulary is different than the rest of the gospel. However, the biggest giveaway for me is that when you take a step back and look at chapter 7 and 8 in context, the story of the woman caught in adultery interrupts the account of Jesus speaking with the Pharisees at the Feast of Tabernacles. Go ahead, take a look. But to get a better perspective, try to ignore the chapter and verse numbers. They were added after the fact for reference purposes only. At the end of John chapter 7, Jesus is in a heated conversation with the Pharisees after just declaring himself to be the Messiah to the crowd gathered at the Feast of Tabernacles. The dialogue between Jesus and the Pharisees centers around his claim to be God. Suddenly, we're in the story of the woman caught in adultery. Then, after all the Pharisees are gone, leaving only Jesus and the woman, verse 12 says, Jesus spoke to them again, I am the light of the world. And the dialogue with the Pharisees about Jesus' claim to be God picks right back up again for the rest of chapter 8. So now let's address the elephant in the room. Why is this section in the Bible if it probably wasn't there in the first place? Well, it's because of the key word in that question, probably. There are a lot of scholars that think that this story has historical veracity, meaning that it did actually happen. It could have been a piece of oral tradition, later to be recorded, or it very well could have been written by John, just as it's recorded in chapter 8. The reality is that it is possible to be wrong on the issue, and therefore it's a really good idea to consider the meaning of the passage and to leave it right where it is in the text, with a little note in the margin. Check your margin, near John chapter 7, verse 53. If there's a note, like mine, it might say something like, the words "and everyone" in 7 verse 53, through "sin no more" in verse 11, are bracketed by NU text as not original. They are present in over 900 manuscripts. Personally, I'm glad this passage of scripture was included in the text because it gives us further insight into Jesus' character and his ability to avoid being backed into a corner by the Pharisees who sought to trap him. The trap was simple. After bringing the woman caught in adultery to Jesus, the Pharisees presented Jesus with two options. Either stone her to death, or let her live. If he refused to do what the law said and stone her, then they could accuse him of rejecting the Mosaic law and his credibility would have been gone. If he fulfilled the law and stoned her to death, then his reputation for being a man of compassion and forgiveness would be tarnished. But Jesus knew the hearts of these men, and with that knowledge, revealed a third option, to expose their own hearts to them. He said, "Let him who is without sin among you throw the first stone at her." I love that the oldest of the men left first. They had the longest span of life to reflect back on, and their own sinfulness quickly became evident to them. And one by one, they all walked away, humbled by their encounter with Jesus. The lesson of this story is short but powerful. Jesus looks at the woman, and he says, "Has no one condemned you? Neither do I condemn you." But just before the story ends with the idea that Jesus tolerates sinful behavior, he says to her, "Go and sin no more." What a clear picture of the nature of God's grace. His inability to tolerate sin requires that sin must not go unpunished. But his love for mankind is so great that he provides himself a substitutionary sacrifice to satisfy the requirement for sin. It is because of Jesus that our sin was dealt with, so God's perfect nature would remain intact and enable him to look at us and say, "Neither do I condemn you. Go and sin no more."